Total Sport North East.
The EFL Cup.
BBC Radio Newcastle.
And good evening again from St James's Park. About 15 minutes to go until we get underway tonight against AFC Wimbledon of League Two up against Newcastle United. The rearranged, switched tie in the third round of the competition. And Newcastle with 8 changes this evening. But still what looks like a strong team, named by Eddie Howe. Dubravka in goal, Livramento, Kraft, Cher, who'll captain the side, and Kelly in defence. Longstaff, Willock, Joe Linton in midfield. Almiron, Barnes, and a full debut, first start for Newcastle, for Osula up front. And on the bench, 2 goalkeepers, Ruddy and the lesser-spotted Odysseus. Tonali, Gordon, Hall, Jacob Murphy, Alex Murphy, Byrne, and Bruno. Those are the Newcastle replacements tonight. If it's level after 90 minutes, just as against Nottingham Forest in the last stage of the League Cup, then it's straight to penalties, no extra time at this point in the competition. And at this stage last season, Newcastle entered the League Cup through being in Europe, and they beat Manchester City here, I'm sure you remember, by a goal to nil scored by Alexander Isak. That was their third round tie last year. Tonight it's AFC Wimbledon, whose players are applauding their 1,500 or so supporters who've travelled up at relatively short notice, John Anderson, haven't they, to get here, the Wimbledon fans. They obviously went through a lot as a club, and still are, with the situation with their pitch, but I'm sure their supporters would ordinarily, and I think they will be tonight, be delighted to come and watch their team play somewhere like this at a packed, sold out St James's Park.
Yeah, it's a big night for them. Look, a disappointment for them last week with what happened to the ground and what happened to the pitch. I'm sure they would have preferred to have played the game in their own stadium, in their own backyard. Would have been a tougher game. I would have been more fearful going down there last week, I have to admit, especially after the Fulham game. But being back here after the game at the weekend and the performance that we put in, you know, you would expect us to have too much. Great night for a lot of these Wimbledon players as well to play in a stadium like this in front of a sellout crowd. So yeah, they'll enjoy it. No pressure on them. They can go and play, go and enjoy it. But I still feel that we're going to have far too much fun.
And they've gone in early to their changing room, Wimbledon. The players have just left the pitch. Newcastle finishing off their warm-ups now. Fabian Cher, who'll skipper the team tonight, heads back down the tunnel. He's gone strong, Eddie Howe, hasn't he? We knew there'd be changes. 8 is quite a lot, but when you think about the changes he's made, some of them make perfect sense.
I thought he would have made more.
Do you think he would have possibly?
Yeah.
It's just about, it's yeah, probably, with still a couple of injuries, maybe about where he could go and what he can do if he was to make more changes. But I mean, 8, Joe Linton, Cher and Barnes keep their place from Saturday against Manchester City. But the likes of Willock coming in, get to see Livramento at right back. Kelly, who started a few Premier League games this season. You know, those are players that will be in and out of the Newcastle team, you would think. Or maybe in the case particularly of Willock, he'll be more in than out, as long as he stays fit.
Look, I think you need to get game time into these players' legs. You know, some of them haven't played for a while. They need to get a game under the belt. I think the side that plays at Everton picks itself, to be quite honest, Reza. You know, it's the side that started against Manchester City. You know, it was a side that went out. Energy levels were really high. Intensity was there. So I think he sticks with that starting 11. But it's an opportunity for some of these other boys tonight to get game time. And look, they need to go and they need to perform. They need to put a seed in the manager's head. Not that he doesn't already know what they're about, but to show that they're in form and that they can be relied upon to go and do a job if needed.
No Trippier, no Pope in the Newcastle squad tonight. Pope, we imagine, having a night off. Trippier had a bit of a knock on Saturday, but Eddie Howe said yesterday when he held a press conference that Trippier was looking all right, but we'll get another update from Eddie Howe on injuries and that kind of thing after the match. Wimbledon, Their opponents haven't played for 10 days because of postponements. Their last match was a goalless draw with Bradford in League 2, but they were supposed to play Accrington at the weekend. That was called off because it was a home fixture. And they're also supposed to play Crewe at home tonight as well, but that one has been moved to accommodate this fixture against Newcastle United. Their team, they've got three changes from the match against Bradford. They line up like this. I think it's probably a 4-4-2. Owen Goodman is the goalkeeper. He's on loan from Crystal Palace, an England under 20 international. At right back, Hussein Byler, Joe Lewis and Riley Harbottle at centre back, with Isaac Ogundia at left back. Now Ogundia is the player who scored the winning penalty in the shootout victory over Ipswich in the last round. Wimbledon have already knocked out a Premier League team from this season's League Cup. The midfield for the visitors: James Tilley, James Ball, Callum Maycock, who they signed from Solihull of non-league in the summer, actually played against Gateshead in the FA Trophy final at Wembley, which Gateshead won under the management of Rob Elliott, who today has become the new manager of Crawley in League One, the former Newcastle goalkeeper. And Miles Hippolyte, a Grenadian international, is on the left-hand side for Wimbledon, although he might be on the right. He and Tilley, we're told, could switch flanks. They can both play on either side. And the two forward players, Joe Piggott, who's on loan from Leyton Orient, who scored in their win over Bromley in the first round of the League Cup, and Omar Bugel, who was one of their players on target in the draw with Wimbledon before they won the penalty shootout. He's been around, Bugel, playing in non-league for a number of years with the likes of Forest Green and Sutton. And he got 14 goals for Wimbledon last season. So that's how the visitors look. The bench is Lewis Ward, the goalkeeper, James Furlong, Jonjoe O'Toole, probably the most experienced player they have. He's 35. He's played more than 500 appearances across his career in the Football League. He was on the bench here for Northampton when they played cup tie against Newcastle during the Steve McLaren era at St James's Park. Also a substitute for Wimbledon: Josh Kelly, Josh Neufville, Alistair Smith, Matty Stevens, Morgan Williams and Aaron Sasu. We're live on BBC Radio Newcastle from St James's Park. Sunderland's match against Derby in the Championship from the Stadium of Light, with Nick Barnes and Gary Bennett. He's on DAB and Freeview Channel 719. So if you're looking for the Sunderland coverage, then you need Freeview Channel 719 or BBC Radio Newcastle through DAB. That's where you'll hear the Sunderland coverage. We'll be all back together at half-time and then again at the end of the match, right the way through until 10 on BBC Radio Newcastle, with some post-match analysis and, if we can, some dressing room reaction. But otherwise, our post-match interviews always go on the BBC Newcastle Twitter page. Looking at Newcastle's team tonight, and Owen, particularly centre forward, with William Osula starting. We always expected him to play this match, whether it was going to be away or home, as it is now tonight. He came on late at Fulham, wasn't really involved in the match too much, but we like what we saw of 21-year-old Osula in the pre-season game that he played against Brest. Difficult to make a fair judgment of a player based on about an hour's football in a friendly, but we could see some of the qualities on that day that he clearly possesses.
Yeah, he's quick, he's athletic, strong. Listening to Eddie Howe, they feel that he's still got stuff to work on. They obviously feel that he's not quite ready for Premier League football yet. So there's parts of his game that he needs to improve on. But this is a good opportunity for him tonight. You know, not being disrespectful to Wimbledon, but he's playing against League Two players. You know, he's playing against a League Two side. He should be able to show his capabilities. He looked lively in that pre-season game. You know, he had one run where he showed explosive pace, got past people, but difficult to judge players in pre-season games, you know, because they're not played at full pace, because you're not at full pelt. It's really, really difficult, but you can see he has something about him. They obviously feel he's got a little way to go, but tonight's a starting block for him.
BBC Radio Newcastle with a little over 5 minutes to go at St James's Park, placing the fourth round of the League Cup and a home tie against Chelsea on Wednesday the 30th of October, so at the end of the month, 4 weeks away. The fourth round tie will be played, either Newcastle United or Wimbledon, who were knocked out of last season's competition by Chelsea, will host them in the next stage. If you are looking for the Sunderland match, it's definitely on DAB on BBC Radio Newcastle, and I gave you the wrong preview channel number because they've changed it. We are now BBC Radio Newcastle on preview channel 711, not 719 anymore, 711 is where Nick Barnes and Gary Bennett are with the build-up to Sunderland against Derby. We'll continue our build-up to Newcastle United's League Cup tie now by hearing from Eddie Howe. 2 years after he took them all the way to Wembley, Eddie Howe is looking to go on another League Cup run.
The early rounds were very difficult that season, and I think we survived the penalty shootout within that. Very fine margins. We managed to battle our way through a couple of difficult rounds. And then I think it built up. I think you get to the quarterfinal, the semi-final was, you know, the semi-final two games were really memorable for us. And then, of course, you've got a chance to win a trophy. So I think the early rounds are hugely important. You can't take anything lightly. We know how difficult every game is. So this is really where you set the opportunity to potentially win a trophy. So we take with the utmost importance.
This was supposed to be an away tie for you, but after everything that happened to AFC Wimbledon last week, how much are you looking forward to welcoming them and hosting them?
Yeah, we are. I mean, it's not every day that what happened has happened. You know, we switched the venues. We wish them well, and we hope that they get their ground back to a level where it can host games very soon. For us, we take the game seriously, whether it's home or away. They've started the season very well, very strong team. They've got really good attributes in their play, very, very good from set plays, really, really strong. Very well organised defensively. They've been excellent in their own league this year. They've been watertight. So we've got a challenge to, of course, break them down and to create chances, but also nullify their physical strength.
Total Sport
Northeast. Matthew Risbeck and black and white legend John Anderson.
BBC Radio Newcastle.
And Eddie Howe knows what it's like to manage at the level Wimbledon play at, and he also said before the match that he understands exactly what this sort of opportunity means to them. He was manager of Bournemouth, appointed in 2008 when they were at the bottom of the Football League. He took them through the divisions. He had two spells in charge with a time at Burnley in the middle. But he can really understand the scale of the occasion for a club in League Two, a club that's been through a heck of a lot. Wimbledon, or AFC Wimbledon as they are now, having reformed in 2002, and I'm sure he appreciates the other side of this tonight, while obviously looking to get Newcastle into the next round.
Yeah, look, you know, he started at the bottom, didn't he? You know, he started his managerial career at the bottom. He walked his way up, did an unbelievable job at Bournemouth throughout the leagues. He knows what it's all about, but when he first started, the game has moved on since then. Management has moved on since then. The way the game is played, the way players are looked after, all that's moved on as well. So, first and foremost, his main thought will be to get through this. You know, yes, it's tough what's happened to Wimbledon, but we've got an opportunity because of the situation that happened with Wimbledon's ground and whatnot. We get the opportunity to play them in our own backyard, and we've got to make sure that we take full advantage of that.
And here they are, the two teams, to the sound of the familiar sound that Newcastle United walk out to. Local Hero, or Going Home, the theme from Local Hero, to give it its correct back title. They changed the pre-match music on Saturday. Did you notice that? They played this song earlier, and then they played, I think it was a version of the Blades and Races, wasn't it? As the teams were lining up. So they've obviously put it back to what it was.
I didn't notice that. My concentration levels were focused on the game, Razor, so I didn't.
See, that's... One of us is a former player, one of us isn't. And that's the mindset that you need. So fair enough. Newcastle wearing black, white and green tracksuit top. Wimbledon with navy and yellow. They take their jackets off on a chilly night, but the rain has stopped, which is good news. And the away side all in blue with a bit of yellow trim. Goalkeeper in yellow with white gloves and white boots. And for Newcastle, black and white stripes, black shorts, white socks. Dubravka wearing pink this evening. Referee is Darren Bond, who's from Lancashire, and he was refereeing in the championship at the weekend, Preston away at Millwall. Millwall won 3-1.
Do you know when we had this referee last?
In the championship season.
Both games against Derby County.
Yeah, which is a quirk of the refereeing appointment system,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah.
Home and away, and not since. For, what is that, 7-8 years for Darren Bond. He's a referee. Simon Bennett, Andrew Fox are the assistants. The fourth official is Tony Harrington, who's from Hartlepool. And there's no VAR tonight, obviously, so it's ridiculous. You're going to miss it.
Not particularly, but it's crazy. I mean, if you've got it, surely you've got to use it. But it comes in the next round, doesn't it? It comes in the later round.
Yes, it does, yes.
That just doesn't make sense to me. If you've got it in a ground, why not use it? You should use it, especially if you're going to use it in the later rounds as well. Crazy.
Newcastle's players are in a huddle. Fabian Scher does the coin toss with the captain tonight from AFC Wimbledon. Joe Lewis, the centre-back. And then Scher goes to join his teammates next to the centre circle. Wimbledon, Goodman in goal. Byler, Lewis, Harbottle, Ogundia. That's the back four. Tilly, Ball, Maycock, Hippolyte in midfield. Bugill and Piggott up front. Newcastle United, 8 changes from Manchester City. It's very different going from Manchester City at home to AFC Wimbledon at home, but there's a job to be done again. And it's Dubravka in goal, first appearance of the season. Nick Pope played in the last round. Livramento, Kraft, Captain Scher and Kelly. Longstaff, Joe Linton, Willock. Almiron, whose two starts this season have been in the League Cup. Barnes and a full debut wearing number 18 for William Osula. And on the United bench, Ruddy, Odysseus, Tonali, Gordon Hall, Jacob Murphy, Byrne, Alex Murphy and Bruno. BBC Radio Newcastle and NUFC TV at St James's Park with the lights on and Wimbledon kicking us off, shooting towards the Gallagher end of the first half. So Newcastle kicking to our left up the hill, and they've got a bit of defending to do on the far side. Kraft with a couple of challenges, Joel Linton with a block. Wimbledon competitive play on the edge of the area, then Almiron tries to keep it in on the far side but can't. Throw for the visitors. And after 20 seconds, Jason Tindall is told not to stand next to Eddie Howe and go and sit on the bench.
Different standards from referees in the Championship in League 1 and 2.
To be fair to the fourth official, Tony Harrington, they were having a laugh about it, but they've probably had that situation in the Premier League before. First touch for Osula, a header 30 yards from Newcastle's goal, out to Barnes, wide left. They give it to Kelly, up the line to Osula, through the legs of the defender, Riley Harbottle, who's clattered him, and Osula has won a free kick. Neat little touch, nice Newcastle move, free kick in the Wimbledon half, back to halfway, Scher across to Kraft. Livramento, got a long sleeve white shirt on under his black and white jersey, Livramento. Joe Linton for Almiron. Close to the right touchline. Back to Kraft. And still with Emil Kraft up the line to Livramento. It's played in to the Newcastle half. Kraft has to chase after it. Martin Dubravka, good 10 yards up from the edge of the penalty area, receives the ball, passes it to Fabian Scher, and it's dinked in behind. Lloyd Kelly on the run, gets there, keeps it in, and the cross is behind off the defender. Corner kick for Newcastle United.
Yeah, good little ball into the space over the top by Scher. Kelly got himself on his bike.
We've played just over 2 minutes, and the corner kick for Newcastle to be sent in by Sean Longstaff, and it's a low ball to Barnes. Gives it back to Longstaff. Livramento, and they've lost their initiative there, Newcastle. Livramento wasn't sure where to go, instead turned, square ball to Scher. Now Willock, left side of central midfield. Longstaff back to Willock. They are 35 yards out, into the box for Asula to chase, and ball's just beaten him. Goal kick for Wimbledon, cheered by their supporters looking down from on high behind that goal at the Leasers end.
Yeah, a ball like that with all the rain that we had is just going to take off, isn't it, as soon as it hits the surface.
BBC Radio Newcastle, let me remind you, if you're looking for Sunderland against Derby, then you need BBC Radio Newcastle through DAB or on Freeview Channel 711. That's where you'll find the Sunderland coverage tonight. Kraft to Scher, edge of Newcastle's box. Eddie Howe off his bench quickly to encourage the players. Willock running in behind. Kelly, short ball instead to Barnes. Willock was running in behind, in between defenders. Wanted it, just dropped over the top. It didn't go. It's back to Scher. Up to Almiron in the centre circle. Good take and turn from Almiron, being pulled back. Referee lets it go. William Osula is in. Still Osula behind for a corner. The defender recovered and managed to scramble it behind after Almiron rolled it through for the Dane. Just couldn't find the space to get a shot away.
No, just couldn't get it out of his feet, could he? Great little turn by Almiron. Defender gets really tight, just gets rolled. Plays Asula in, just can't get it out of his feet.
The ball is in from the corner. Joel Linton's got it on the far side. They've sent it from left to right. Almiron trying to beat a couple of defenders, but it's a goal kick.
Yeah, that was promising. His first touch was just needed to get it out of his feet so he could get the shot away. It was too, touch was too slight.
0-0 after 5 minutes. First meeting since AFC Wimbledon were formed in 2002, but there were many battles with the old Wimbledon and Newcastle United over the years, including during their time in the Premier League. Last played each other as Wimbledon go back from halfway to the goalkeeper in 99-2000. 3-3 at St James's towards the end of Ruud Hullett's time, and then a 2-0 defeat at Selhurst Park. They didn't like playing Wimbledon at Selhurst Park, Newcastle, did they? They had a terrible record.
Didn't like playing Wimbledon away anywhere.
You'd have played in a few of those, wouldn't you?
A few of them, yeah.
They are a new club, but to all intents and purposes, it's the same Wimbledon. And if you're a younger supporter and you don't know the history, I haven't got time to go into it now while Newcastle play the ball around at the back, but a story well worth reading about what happened to the old club with Milton Keynes and how the new one came into existence and rose up non-league to the Football League. Throw for United, Almiron on Newcastle's right, back into his own half to Kraft. They stretch the play. Barnes on the near touchline, gets it from Kelly, who goes beyond, looking for Willock with a ball inside, couldn't hold it. It's a forward pass from James Ball, giant midfielder in the middle of the park for the visitors. And they've won a free kick just inside Newcastle's half. The manager is Johnny Jackson. And he's off the bench for the first time to communicate with his players. Former Premier League player with Spurs, Johnny Jackson, in the 2000s. The free kick up the line, Kelly has kept it in and cleared it up the line, but it's out. Hasn't been what you'd call a fast start or a dominant start. They've had a couple of set pieces and the through ball for Asula, really.
You've got to realise it's a side that's not played together as well. You know, it's a lot of squad players in there.
Wimbledon with a long throw into the United box. Lloyd Kelly wins the header. Another Wimbledon header. And a second Wimbledon header. And Joe Linton needs to be careful with Bugle. Not to foul him. Managed just to release it him in time. Wimbledon cross from the right. Headed up by Cher. And behind for a corner. Free but kick. Referee says it's a foul.
Dangerous ball, wasn't it?
Good whip on the cross from Hussein Byler, the right back. Fabian Cher had to get there. Plenty of noise coming from the 1500 away fans. Kraft to Almiron. Got Livramento rather just next to Almiron. Livramento stayed up as part of the forward line. Almiron's dropped in and tucked in a bit into midfield. They go up this side instead to Joe Willock, who's on the chase but is beaten by the ball from Lloyd Kelly.
Yeah, that's that straight ball again. You know, as I said earlier on, the amount of rain that we've had, as soon as a ball hits that pitch, just taken off, isn't it? Just skidding away. Got to be so precise with it.
And Kelly acknowledged that the ball had been overhit as Willock tried to race onto it. Goal kick has been taken by goalkeeper Goodman, a Crystal Palace lone player. And now Kelly with a ball, that's a better one for Barnes in the final third. Good cross in by Barnes, headed away, straight back to him by defender Riley Harbottle. Barnes again, flat cross which is blocked by the first defender, and Wimbledon up towards halfway to Bugle, who's ridden a couple of challenges, and the referee felt that there wasn't an advantage with Wimbledon in possession on halfway through. The other centre forward, Joe Piggott, he's brought it back for the second tackle, which was from Lloyd Kelly.
Yeah, he just took him out, didn't he?
After Bugle got away from Emil Kraft. Nil-nil after 10 minutes. Newcastle line up across the middle of their half. It's high line, Wimbledon from just behind halfway. It's flat and then helped on, but straight to a black and white shirt. Kelly goes back to Dubravka, takes
poor
a touch.
Poor free kick, wasn't it? Really poor.
Pushes it onto Kraft, right corner of the area. Livramento gets it, Almiron up the line. Livramento, back it comes to Emil Kraft. Fabian Cher, 10 yards behind halfway, sweeps it across to Kraft. Willock through the middle next to Osula. They go short to Almiron. Inside Wimbledon territory now. Livramento back to him from Longstaff. Joe Linton across to Willock. And Barnes, 30 yards out, up to Kelly. Back inside to Willock. Newcastle trying to move it about and move Wimbledon around. Cher misses out Kraft and it comes to Livramento, on for Almiron, chance to beat his defender, drifts in off the right touchline. Almiron over to Kelly, Barnes is wide.
Oh, Kelly dear.
With another overhit pass intended for Harvey Barnes.
Ooh.
Straight out of play, nil-nil.
That's just a straightforward ball as well. Barnes had acres of space, he just had to roll it into him. It's just overhit it.
Play it into his path in that position, or you can give it to him to feet, but
yeah,
with that much force behind it, is unlikely to come off. Well, that's a promising position for Newcastle, but they didn't make the most of it. Kraft with a header back to Dubravka from the Wimbledon goal kick, quickly rolled out, underarm to Cher, striding forwards, finds Kelly on halfway. Barnes wanting to run in behind, better ball from Kelly this time. It's had some good and some not quite so good. That was decent. Barnes back to Joel Linton for Longstaff, right side of central midfield. Livramento, Wimbledon, everybody behind the ball, closing off the space. Newcastle having to go backwards with it. Osula makes a run towards the corner of the box, but Kraft up the line to Almiron instead. Joel Linton back to Kraft, gets it again, drops his shoulder and away from Piggott. Up the line to Almiron, who wins a throw. Livramento quickly back in play to Joel Linton, and they return it, Newcastle, to Livramento, who comes into central position with the pass to find Cher. Willock tackled, and Willock recovers under pressure from Bugle on halfway. Cher, great ball to find Almiron in the penalty area. Almiron brings it down.
Offside.
Flags up. Ball goes into the net, but Almiron denied by the offside flag. As Cher went from left centre back towards the penalty box on the far side. Almiron, nice touch and take, but the assistant on the far side, Andrew Fox,
says
he's offside.
Mile off. It's only about 10 yards offside. Good ball over the top though, isn't it?
Livramento with a backwards header. Joel Linton forwards. Almiron, who did put the ball in the net off the goalkeeper there, but not sure whether the goalkeeper had decided to let it go, knowing that the flag was up. It's up at this end now. Newcastle defending the through ball.
Offside then.
Yeah, straight down the middle towards Piggott. And offside against AFC Wimbledon. Emil Kraft crosses halfway. Livramento. Almiron back to Livramento. 10 yards outside the area. Joel Linton. Longstaff gets turned, threads it through for Almiron, who's made a good run. Players waiting for the cross, but headed away. He's looking for Osula in the middle, out of all of his options. And Wimbledon defended it, and now they could counter-attack because they've got away in midfield, and they've got five players in this attack, and they go to Byler, the right fullback. Dangerous ball in, turned behind by Lloyd Kelly.
Good break, wasn't it? Got players forward into advanced positions. Decent little break. Win the corner kick.
On this near side, the ball low, driven in by Byler, who is the furthest player back now. He's retreated. But everybody else, in terms of outfield players, is up for the corner. And Newcastle got everybody back. They have as many as they can into the 6-yard box, but there are a couple hanging further back. It's going to be a left-footed corner from the near right-hand side in the 15th minute towards the back of the 6-yard box, and it's Lloyd Kelly who flicks it away. All those players, they committed and they couldn't pick anybody out, but there were a lot of black and white shirts back. Dubravka then comes in, claims a ball in from Byler from deep. Gives it to Lloyd Kelly. Eddie Howe with a scratch of the head as Kelly comes up to halfway, and Osula chasing, but too much on that one as well. They've obviously felt that that side of the Wimbledon defence, the right side, whether it's centre back, full back, or in between the two of them, is where that they want to aim the balls, because they must feel that maybe it's a pace thing with Osula and Willock, who's obviously willing to get up there and run in behind, that they can get some joy that way. But the distribution from the back from Lloyd Kelly's been hit and miss so far.
Yeah, it's been, as you say, it's been a little bit overhit.
Header from Joe Linton in midfield, looking for Osula, but he couldn't get there. And the League Two side have possession. But they're not keeping it with passes like that. Up the line, nobody there. Newcastle can start another attack. Livramento at walking pace, back to Kraft. And Kelly for Barnes, closed down by Byler, inside to Joe Linton. Cher, his orange boots, sends it forwards to Almiron, takes a touch with his left, in behind Longstaff, in the penalty area, holds it up. Still Sean Longstaff, laid off to Joe Linton, back to Longstaff. Return ball to Longstaff from Livramento, and he gets the shot away, left footed from the edge of the area. Nice pass and move, but straight at the goalkeeper.
Yeah, good little give and go, wasn't it? On his left foot, decent enough strike, but straight into the midriff of the keeper. Decent strike.
No goals yet at St James's Park, and also goalless at Sunderland. Their match against Derby in the Championship. If you want the red and white coverage tonight, our Sunderland commentary on Freeview Channel 711 and BBC Radio Newcastle on DAB from Nick Barnes and Gary Bennett, both 7:45 kickoffs. Livramento in the middle of the Wimbledon half, laid off to Almiron. Osula, who's drifted out to the wide right position, has a couple of touches, and back it goes to Emil Kraft. Share in the centre circle, angled ball over to Kelly, looks for Barnes, almost lost it, was on the floor Barnes when he stabbed it back to Kelly, and they give it to Cher again. Livramento wants to go in behind, it's that ball to the wide right position, the one that Almiron was caught offside from. Cher plays it, Livramento is onside, gives it back to Almiron, who then tries to get Kelly in behind, but it's a goal kick.
Yeah, too straight a ball again.
Twentieth minute at St James's Park. Eight times in a row, including this one, have Newcastle been drawn away from home in domestic cup competitions over the last couple of seasons, since the Manchester City tie that they won at this stage of last year's League Cup. But obviously they're playing this here tonight because it was switched. So it's seven away domestic ties in a row. Even if they were pulled out as the away team for this fixture, and home in the next round, whoever the winners are, Chelsea await. Willock, Kelly goes beyond, they're in the Wimbledon half now. Barnes up there with Osula, Kelly onto Willock, and a return ball, not able to get in behind. How do you feel Wimbledon have defended?
Yeah, and they've done alright, haven't they?
They seem to be very they have a lot of structure.
You can see, well disciplined, aren't they?
Almiron combining with
whip it.
Livramento on the far side, but was on his right foot, so he turned back. He still got it on his left, Almiron. Laid off to Kraft, and having been in the box, Newcastle, they're now back on halfway. And starting again with Cher to Kelly. 0-0. Barnes. Turn of pace from Barnes. And a big switch of play from left to right, but it's between Livramento and Almiron. And out of play it goes. It hasn't quite come together in the opening.
No, that wasn't good, was it?
Pass. Opening quarter of tonight's match. Wimbledon have got a player in the meantime getting some treatment. Joe Piggott, striker on loan from Leyton Orient, he's now back on. Newcastle in the final third with Kelly. Willock on the outside, Barnes in the middle. Joe Willock for Sean Longstaff. Carried it back over to the left wing. Gets it back from Kelly. Longstaff turns in the corner. Has has it on his right foot. And rather than whipping it in, back down the line to Cher. Looking for an opening goal, Newcastle, with Joel Linton and Longstaff helping it on. But Wimbledon have got it. And Piggott here. A couple of ricochets, but he's come away with it. And a chance to attack up the far side, maybe, with James Tilley. He has
run it out of play.
Lost his bearings and carried the ball over the line. Newcastle throw, applause for players warming up, including Lewis Hall. Anthony Gordon's just been out there as well. Eight changes for Newcastle tonight. They've got it at the back through Cher. He's one of three survivors from Saturday in the starting 11. Dubravka, Livramento, Kraft, Cher, Kelly, Joel Linton, Longstaff, Willock, Almiron, Barnes and Osula is the starting 11. Kelly's seen loads of the ball on this near side. He's got it again. Finds Joel Linton. Longstaff brings in Livramento. Space on the far side. Comes in off the touchline. Drops it off to Kraft. And Livramento back to Kraft again. Joel Linton in the centre. Plays it backwards to Cher. Willock with Kelly wide left. That's where it goes. Into Barnes, back to Willock, trying to move it with more speed. Newcastle, Joel Linton looking for Willock, but Wimbledon slide in and divert the ball away, and then it's cleared up towards the halfway line. Bugle and Cher, and a foul by the Newcastle defender who had hold of the striker. Darren Bond gives the League Two team the decision.
Yeah, he's having a go at the referee, but you can have no complaints. Had hold of him.
Somewhat what we've watched from Newcastle, John Anderson, in the opening 24 minutes.
Some good, some bad. Kelly's getting plenty of the ball as usual. It hasn't been great up to now. I mean, that's an awful free kick as well. Straight into the arms of Dubravka. But it's always difficult as well, Razor, when, you know, he's made eight changes. A lot of these players haven't played together in a competitive game. Still finding their way, but it's been okay.
Livramento has got a run from Longstaff, headed out by Joe Lewis for Wimbledon. Throw taken on the far side, back to Kraft. Longstaff's got pressure on him from Hippolyte. He's playing on the Wimbledon midfield left side. Forced him to go back to halfway to Emil Kraft. Fabian Cher with the ball, and Lloyd Kelly again. Sula starts to make a run the left channel. Ball doesn't come his way. Then Newcastle have lost it in midfield through Joel Linton. Nice turn from Piggott, gets it back from Bugle. Some excitement from the away fans as they put together a nice move into Newcastle's half, and that's a good switch. And Byler couldn't hold it, clipped him on the chest and went up and then out. But a nice pass pinged across, wasn't it, from Tilley. They're actually playing with a back five, Wimbledon. It's a 5-3-2. Certainly when Newcastle have the ball, at least. Tilley at left wing back. Now Newcastle with a diagonal switch from Cher to Barnes. Great first touch. Barnes on his right. Goes for the top corner. Curler from Harvey Barnes just didn't bend back in time. Decent effort. And the closest
what he
Newcastle
likes to do,
have
isn't
come
it?
Tonight.
That's what he likes to do. Just cut in on that right foot and whip. Wasn't that far away. It wasn't too far away.
It remains 0-0 on BBC Radio Newcastle. Crowd fairly quiet as well this evening, looking for goals to get them going. It's a throw for Livramento on the far side, right side of defence. And Cher on the near side now, up to Kelly. Sula ready to run in behind at every opportunity. And this time it's Almiron who gets there. Miguel Almiron over the top.
Got to do better.
They played one in behind, and Almiron had made the run from right to left, took a touch, and the keeper advancing off his line. Almiron went for power and cleared the crossbar from just inside the Wimbledon area. It's a good chance. It should be 1-0.
Yeah, just lashed it, didn't he? No composure there at all, was there? Big chance.
Header on by Wimbledon looking for Piggott from Bugle, but Fabian Cher makes the block. Newcastle with Lloyd Kelly charging forwards up the near side, turns infield, gets it back from Joe Linton, gives it to him again, and the Brazilian's ball in a little gap between Wimbledon players for Kraft. A bit more intensity about Newcastle now, 28 minutes. Close a couple of times with Barnes and then Almiron. Longstaff near to the right corner of the penalty area. Scorer of the winning penalty in the last round at Nottingham Forest, Sean Longstaff. Restored to the team tonight. Back to Cher. Kelly for Willock, 10 yards outside the area. Barnes comes in off the near touchline, back to him from Joe Linton. He goes on the outside again to Willock, closed down by two blue shirts. Willock finds Cher, plays it 10 yards to the right to Kraft. Now Almiron twists and turns. Almiron floats it over towards Barnes. Byler rises to nod it away. Kelly to Barnes, beats a couple of players, and there's a wall of blue in his way, and he has to go square. Kraft, they wanted to shoot, picks out the pass, and it's to Livramento, comes in off the right wing. Joe Linton back to Cher, still 0-0 at St James's. Fabian Cher on to Livramento, nobody yet finding space or the inclination to take the shot on. Almiron has it just outside the right corner of the penalty box. Joe Linton, Wimbledon camped on the edge of their 18-yard area. Barnes for Willock, Kelly on the outside. Willock gives it back to Barnes. Newcastle moving it quickly, and now they find Livramento in space on the far side, into the middle of the penalty area, and it just missed Osula and Willock, and it's half cleared. Kelly makes a challenge, Willock then gets it back. Willock with a step over and then a turn, drops it off to Barnes, back to Cher.
Yeah, the pressure's intensifying, isn't it?
And they come again, the far side, with Almiron. Joe Linton back to Almiron, he's hit the referee.
Well played, ref.
He's looking for Cher in the middle. Wimbledon, every player within 25, 30 yards of their goal, as Newcastle play it around, try and move them right to left. And the team sixth in League Two, despite not having played the weekend. The teams have played two matches more. They'll be delighted to be half an hour in and still be 0-0. Longstaff stabs the ball forwards. Almiron and Osula chase it, but Goodman slides along the turf towards the side of the penalty area and makes the claim. He saved two penalties, Owen Goodman, in the shootout against Ipswich in the last round to send Wimbledon through and reach this stage of the League Cup. And a big kick out of his hands. Cher on the stretch, It had gone over his head, stuck out his right leg and made contact and hooked it over to Lloyd Kelly. Supporters wanting to see more urgency from Newcastle. It reached halfway with Kelly and then it went backwards. Kraft, Joel Linton, Osula just outside the box, all good shift. Then Osula went for a curler, but it's too high. Nice take, and then a shift to find the space for the shot, but he's off target, William Osula.
Yeah, good take. Got it out of his feet on this occasion, but always leaning back. Ball's always rising over the top. Pressure's up a little bit, doesn't it?
The applause is for Bruno and Tonali, who have been instructed by Eddie Howe to warm up, along with young defender Alex Murphy. Joel Linton with a header that goes backwards. Wimbledon make a challenge, and then Longstaff plays it to Dubravka. And they're getting it out quickly. They're always getting it out quickly to Kelly, aren't they? And there's a quick one up the line from Kelly for Barnes. Defender gets
great
across.
Tackle.
And
well
the referee
played.
Says...
Yeah.
Whoa.
Well played.
It's Newcastle's throw. It's the assistant who's flagging. Just wondered whether it had gone for a corner, but it hadn't.
Yeah, good defending, wasn't it?
Riley Harbottle, who made the challenge, I think, for Wimbledon. Number 26. That's him. Kraft. Livramento and Almiron exchange passes on the far side. Now in the attacking third, Newcastle with Longstaff. Almiron again. Jason Tindall side by side with Eddie Howe, talking and pointing as Barnes breaks into the penalty area. Two to beat, still going. Harvey Barnes decides to stop and just give it to Lloyd Kelly, who sticks it in. It's a corner. The cross has gone behind off a blue shirt, and I think that one hurt. It could be winded, or it may have hit them a bit lower. The Wimbledon midfielder Callum Maycock took a whack there, and it's a sore one. Longstaff back to Willock. Livramento has played the pass to Barnes on the left again. Barnes into the area, finds space, shot is blocked. Comes over to the far side, Fabian Scher first there, back to Livramento. A lot of fans wanted Livramento to just hit it, Ando, and he had to.
It's a long, way out though, isn't he?
No one closed him down. Barnes in the end took the shot. And they've recycled the move, Newcastle, 0-0 on BBC Radio Newcastle. Livramento, Osula drops off, finds Longstaff. No offside flag, Longstaff forced out wide towards the corner. And then Almiron into the middle. Not really sure what that was from Almiron, just looked like he tried to scoop it up and away from a defender. It reached the box and then the goalkeeper picked it up.
Yeah, this is it when it keeps wanting to come back on that left foot, doesn't he?
Kraft with some defending to do. It's out of play from the Swede. Couldn't find Livramento. Wimbledon can push up. 10 minutes to half time. Still goalless Sunderland derby on Freeview Channel 711 and BBC Radio Newcastle DAB. That's where the Sunderland commentary is tonight. And no goals at St James's Park either. Long throw from Wimbledon. Looped up into the box towards the near post, headed away by Willock. They'll be disappointed with that. They have a chance to send the ball back in again from across, and they do, and Piggott, and now an opportunity for Bugle, and Dubravka gets down bravely to make the block.
Offside.
And he's been hurt.
Offside.
Flags up anyway, but he wasn't to know that. The striker bearing down on goal. Dubravka came out to stop him, made the block, but he's been caught, and Newcastle's medical team come sprinting on. It remains 0-0 thanks to Dubravka's stop, but then the offside flag would have denied Wimbledon anyway. looks like he may have been caught in the chest.
Yeah, to be fair to the striker, he had every right to go for it, didn't he? Just bounced between them.
Dubravka receiving treatment. John Ruddy is one of two goalkeepers on the bench, along with Odysseus. Odysseus Vlachodimos, but he likes to be known just as Odysseus. And the Greek goalkeeper has got off his seat, but Ruddy has gone to do some stretches in the corner. Martin Dubravka's first Newcastle appearance of the campaign is possibly under threat here, because he doesn't look in a good way. He's now lying down in the 6-yard box. He's got a problem with his left leg, some part of his left leg. He got caught, I think, by a stud in the chest or midriff, but maybe there was contact lower down as well. Still working on Dubravka. 0-0, 38th minute. Players have been across for a drink, and now there's conversations going on the pitch. Almiron and Kelly, Barnes and Osula, Joelinton, Livramento and Longstaff together, separately. John Ruddy continues to warm up. Dubravka pulled up to his feet, and the doctor is in communication with the bench. Dubravka not looking particularly comfortable, but he'll be determined to continue. And they haven't called for John Ruddy to come on yet, but he's bent over, Dubravka, and limping.
Yeah, alright.
Now down on his haunches. Fabian Scher gives him a rub on the head. The doctor and the physio come off the pitch. And he's going to carry on, but obviously took a bit of a whack there.
Yeah, he did. I mean, as I say, the ball broke between the two of them. The forward had every right to go for it. It was a 50-50 ball. Flag went up. I mean, it wasn't a foul. Nope. Referee hasn't given the foul. Hopefully he'll be all right to continue.
Newcastle are playing again. They've restarted the match. Scher to Kraft. Livramento with the ball up towards Osula, blocked by a defender. Now Kelly, just outside the area, Lloyd Kelly, Harvey Barnes. Joelinton back to Barnes. Livramento takes it nicely, 30 yards from the Wimbledon goal, back to Scher. Barnes drops in, and Scher finds him with the pass. Willock could go wide to Lloyd Kelly. Willock threatening to take on a couple of players, eventually gives it to Kelly. Back to Willock again. Now Scher, an inviting ball for Livramento, takes a touch, rolls it forwards. Longstaff in the challenge, and that's a foul on Miles Hippolyte, the Wimbledon midfielder from Sean Longstaff, just next to the penalty area.
It's too pedestrian, isn't it? Too slow, passing the ball slowly. There's not enough pace on the passes either.
0-0 between Newcastle and Wimbledon. Sunderland are leading 1-0 against Derby through Job. Scher's header straight to a blue shirt. Willock, that's a collision. Willock seemed to slip, but then he bundled over Callum Maycock, and free kick for the League Two side, about 10 yards back from the penalty area, right of centre.
Yeah, it's just slid into the back of him, hasn't he? Right in front of the referee as well. I don't think there was a great deal he could do about it, to be fair.
Five players involved in the conversation over who's going to take it. Four of them.
It's a long way out, isn't it? They're not thinking of hitting this, are they?
Well, The four who lose out all walk away, and they leave the ball to James Tilley. He's square to it though, surely he can't wrap his foot around it from there and shoot. Dubravka may be tested here, it's clipped into the box, Livramento's header, they're going to let it run behind, are they? No, kept in on the far side, it would have gone for a corner, and then Newcastle win it back. They should have let it go for the corner. Almiron, Osula tries to challenge on halfway, Wimbledon header, Livramento's got it back and beats one player and then sets Almiron free, and Osula in the middle, Almiron carrying it, and he wins a throw level with the Wimbledon penalty area.
Just hasn't got a right foot, has he?
Foul on Livramento, and Newcastle have a free kick following the throw. About 5 yards back from the corner flag. Well, this is in a wide position, John Anderson, but it's a good position, and Sharon Kraft.
Yeah, it's halfway between the touchline and the 18-yard box. Sean Longstaff standing over it, a couple of yards in from that far touchline.
Here's the ball from the free kick. It hits the first defender, the one-man wall, but Newcastle have it back through Cher on the goal line, trying to win a corner kick, and he's done so. So from the disappointment of the free kick not giving them anything, Fabian Cher makes the most of it. And corner kick to be taken by Longstaff. Everybody in the box bar Longstaff and Livramento, who's holding back. Almiron makes a run, could get it short. It's rolled into the area towards Cher. He's gone down under a challenge. Play on. Almiron, now he goes down, referee has a good look, Darren Bond. Almiron has stayed down, and now what have they given? Newcastle have got a decision, the assistant referee is flagging. Players are going to the referee, has he given a penalty? Didn't well, point to the spot.
No, well the referee hasn't got his flag across his chest, has he? Or the linesman, I should say.
He was flagging and waiting, and then pointed towards the Wimbledon goal in that direction. The referee is going across to speak to a Wimbledon player as a yellow card has been shown to Hussein Byler.
Is it a penalty?
And it is a penalty to Newcastle United. He didn't point to the spot, the referee. He didn't point in a downward direction, and it was the foul on Almiron, it must have been the foul on Almiron from Joe Piggott, that's what's led to the penalty. Byler wasn't involved, maybe it was for something he said.
Took an eternity, didn't it?
It just wasn't clear from the way the referee signaled. He pointed forwards but not toward, not anywhere near the spot. Darren Bond turned down one Newcastle appeal, then they get the second one eventually. It must have been on the advice of the assistant, who was waving his flag, but as you say, didn't put it across his chest.
No.
Fabian Cher's going to take the penalty. Captain tonight. End of the first half. Cher, from 12 yards, rolls it into the net. As cool as you like, as cool as Fabian Cher always is. And with 4 minutes added to the first half, they break the deadlock. From the penalty spot, Fabian Cher, Newcastle United 1, AFC Wimbledon.
Yeah, decent penalty, wasn't it? It's just roll keeper. Wasn't really in the corner either, was it?
Little stutter from Cher in the run-up.
Newcastle, the scorer, number 5, Fabian Cher.
Side-footed it, but as you say, Ando, it's not in the corner. If you went from the centre of the goal to the post, it's probably in between the two, isn't it?
Yeah.
That would be the sort of position. Goalkeeper just probably beaten as much by the run-up and Cher with a bit of disguise rather than the direction of the penalty, but he's reliable from the spot. He scored for Newcastle before. From 12 yards, and he does so tonight. It's second goal of the season following the deflected long-range effort at Wolves. It was all very unclear and low-key, wasn't it, the award of the penalty?
Referee took forever to award it.
Barnes and Kelly on the near side for Newcastle. Wimbledon half. Now, there were 4 minutes added, and the numbers board was shown just before the penalty was taken, so they may play on a bit longer. Livramento to Almiron. He's lifted it around a defender. Doesn't get the decision.
Went looking for it, didn't he? Just threw himself to the ground.
It's a throw for AFC Wimbledon. The last time a Wimbledon team won at St James's Park was in September 1997, just a couple of days before Newcastle beat Barcelona in the Champions League. Almiron on the right, looking for Asula and Willock, and headed away by the visitors' defence. Beiler here getting himself into a bit of trouble with Kelly, and got a bit lucky. He got the free kick. Referee saying that Kelly pulled him. Thought he just looked stronger, but had nowhere to go. Beiler got the free kick, and then they've lost it from the free kick. Willock behind the halfway line to Longstaff. And on for Willock again, and now Barnes. Sean Longstaff to Joe Linton. Fabian Scher. He's got an option in space, and it's Emil Kraft to his right-hand side. And Kraft gets it back again from Livramento. 45 yards out, Newcastle. Now trying to make their way into the final third. Osula's layoff. Push on Longstaff. Free kick, 10 yards outside the box on the right. It's half-time at Sunderland. 1-0, they lead against Derby. Simon Pride will be along at the break here on BBC Radio Newcastle. The free kick's been taken, and we have half-time here at St James's Park. Fabian Scher's penalty in the 46th minute, the first of additional time. It's given Newcastle a 1-0 lead over their opponents from League Two here in the third round of the League Cup. What have you made of the first half, John Anderson?
A little bit disjointed. We haven't worked the keeper, have we? You know, he's had the one save to make from Longstaff, but hasn't been great. Wimbledon have been got people behind the ball. They've worked hard, but haven't really carried the threat going forward. It's been, I mean, the penalty just came out of nowhere as well, didn't it?
Yeah, a strange piece of play, and wasn't completely clear. There was no reaction from the crowd, really, was there?
No. No.
I think anybody knew for certain. The referee had made that decision with some help from his assistant. Scher put it away. In terms of other chances, well, Almiron was offside when he got in, and then put the ball into the net off the goalkeeper. Barnes curled one just wide. Osula's had a try. But not loads and loads of opportunities.
No, there hasn't been too many chances in the game. You know, we haven't worked the goalkeeper. Barnes has cut in, he's whipped one wide. But we haven't put the goalkeeper under any real pressure.
Away tickets for,
as far as Wimbledon's concerned, they haven't carried a major threat going forward. We've had the majority of the ball, which would you would have expected, but we need to use more, but we need to be better with it.
The match stats: possession, Newcastle have had 85% of possession. They've had six shots, Wimbledon have had none. Dubravka's not been troubled, apart from the one moment where he got caught, but Bugle was offside. And although Wimbledon created something, the flag went up. Dubravka able to carry on. Just finally for the moment, Ando, if you want to send us a message on WhatsApp, 08000 321 333. Put BBC at the start, 08000 321 333, and BBC at the front of your message, and we'll look at them at half time. William Osula, not really had him in the game, have they?
Haven't seen a great deal of him, to be quite honest. Needs to be more involved, needs to do a little bit more.
Well, Fabian Scher has scored from the penalty spot for Newcastle United, and that is the only goal at half time here at St James's Park on BBC Radio Newcastle. The second half of this League Cup third round tie is coming up shortly at the interval. Newcastle United 1, Wimbledon 0.
Matt Bailey at breakfast.
This morning I want to know, when have you made a lasting impression? Gilly from Frostley, yours happened at work, yeah?
My son had dropped me off. Two customers shouted, Gilly! I just ignored them. My colleague come in and she went, Gilly, do you realise that your skirt is tucked in your knickers? Oh my God! That's what they were trying to tell me, and they come in every single day. I couldn't look them in the face.
Why did your son not tell you? He watched you walk across the car park.
I rang him up, I went, did you not realise? He was like, no, I'm on.
Matt Bailey at breakfast. Back tomorrow when you wake up. BBC Radio Newcastle.
And this is Simon Pride at St James's Park, alongside John Anderson. Newcastle leading Wimbledon by a goal to nil here. Sunderland in the ascendancy as well, 1-0 up over Derby County at the Stadium of Light. I'll have a chat to Marco Gabbiadini, who's watching that one, in a moment. Let's just get some thoughts from Ando, and I will take you through the other scores around the country and around Europe as well, after I've chatted to John and Marco. But Ando, a first half, well, it was a strange penalty award, wasn't it, the way that it happened,
it's
a penalty that separates the sides, and Newcastle probably just about worthy of that advantage. Just
we haven't really worked the goalkeeper, we haven't forced him into any saves, we've had plenty of the ball, plenty of possession, but never really threatened the goal. The penalty was really strange. It took an eternity for the referee to award it. I think that he went and had a word with the assistant, didn't put the flag. No, so he just kept waving his flag all the time. But I have to say, it looked a penalty. It looked like he cleaned it out. Yeah. So
there were two shouts in a row, weren't there? The first one definitely wasn't.
No, the first one definitely wasn't. But the second one, from where we are, it's on the opposite side to us, to be fair. But it looked a definite penalty.
You would think a second goal for Newcastle ends the game in the second half.
Yeah, I mean, to be fair, Wimbledon haven't carried a threat, have they? You know, they've worked hard, they've kept their shape well, they've been disciplined, they've got close. But as I say, from a perspective of getting forward and working the goalkeeper, haven't seen anything from them at all.
Who's impressed you in a Newcastle shirt?
It's been difficult. You know, you can see that they've been. You've got players in there, he's picked a side that hasn't really played together. Back fours, two centre backs, it's been very, very comfortable for them. Kelly's had plenty of the ball, but I just feel his use of the ball's got to be better at times. Barnes on this left side, seen a bit. We know what he wants to do, he wants to cut in and get those shots away.
Asula's not really had much.
No, he hasn't been involved in the game, has he? He needs to go looking for the ball a bit more, he needs to get involved in the game, needs to do a little bit more.
Okay, Ando, thank you. Go and get your half-time cup of tea. Marco, from a Sunderland perspective, well, quite a goal to separate the sides, firstly.
Yeah, absolute cracking goal. Just what was needed, actually, because they have a lot of men behind the ball. They were, you know, five at the back. They were going, you know, very narrow and, you know, blocking all the spaces. So a shot from distance was a good option, and it just opened up for Bellingham, and he took his opportunity absolutely perfectly. So Sunderland were building pressure. You know, I thought Derby started off quite brightly, you know, tried to spring people like Harness forward, and but as the half went on, they just sank deeper and deeper and deeper, and we got more and more possession. So a couple of half chances, Sirkin and Mundell down the left hand side doing a lot of damage. Rigg just starting to get the ball, you know, as it's breaking in tackles and creating a little bit of mischief. But it's been you can see it being quite comfortable if they keep doing the jobs well.
So a similar question to the one I put to Anderson, if they were to get a second goal, you'd be pretty confident that they would be able to see the game out.
Yeah, Derby, I mean, you know, there's always the opportunity as an away team that you, you know, you try and keep it at 1-0 and then bring a couple of substitutes on, freshen it up and go for it big in the last 15 minutes or so. But, you know, I think Sunderland are in a position here where the more possession we have, the deeper they get, the ball's going to just fall and hopefully we get the chances as we've done in previous games this season. But yeah, two very different sides. Sunderland, you know, building, trying to be patient. You know, when they're getting in the box, a couple of times we haven't quite had enough men in the box when Mundell's put the ball in a few times. We've been a little bit, you know, like Roberts has got to get in from the opposite side and maybe one of the midfielders get a little bit nearer the 6-yard box. But, you know, all in all, it's worked out quite well.
Anyone in a Sunderland shirt that's impressed you particularly?
Well, again, Mundell, you know, he's just, we obviously go to that side a lot, but he's got a lot of tricks. He's keeping possession. When it gets a little bit too tight, he's rolling it, and him and Sirkin, I like, you know, there's been a few back heels and a few overs, and you know, so it's been quite interesting watching those two. They've got a really good understanding of each other, and I think that's where the main axis of our attacks has come from. But yeah, I mean, we had to be strong at the back. They're putting a few balls in the box, and Mepham and Luca and I have done well in the heart of the defence just to repel everything so far.
Marco, thank you very much indeed. Keep the messages coming in. We'll do some at full time with Benno at the Stadium of Light and Ando here at St James's Park. And of course, plenty more reaction on Total Sport tomorrow evening. And back to second half commentary from both of the games very soon. In the meantime, let me tell you what's happening elsewhere. Plenty of goals around in the Championship. A big programme of fixtures in the Championship tonight. Sunderland could go back on top of the pile, depending on how other results turn out, as well as their own. Burnley lead Plymouth by a goal to nil. Josh Brownhill from the penalty spot on 26 minutes there. Cardiff a one-up against Millwall. Ung with the goal 6 minutes before half-time. Jake Bidwell has scored for Coventry, so they lead Blackburn, one of the teams in hot pursuit of Sunderland towards the top of the division. Coventry leading though by a goal to nil. Luton leads Oxford by 2-1. Jordan Clark and Tom Krause putting Luton 2 up. Goodrum getting one back for Oxford on the stroke of half time. Norwich are leading Leeds United by a goal to nil. Josh Sargent from the penalty spot. It's QPR 1, Hull City 2. Cody Drama and Chris Bedia for Hull City. Nicholas Madsen getting one back again from a penalty just before half time for the home side at Loftus Road. And it was an 8 o'clock kickoff at the Hawthorns, still goalless between West Bromwich Albion and Middlesbrough. West Brom currently the only home side in the Championship and not to have scored this evening. In League One, Barnsley 0, Wickham 0, Birmingham 0, Huddersfield 0. No goals either between Blackpool and Lincoln. Bristol Rovers though do lead Charlton by a goal to nil. Cambridge 0, Rotherham 0, Crawley 0, Mansfield Town 1. It's Leighton Orient 0, Exeter 1, Northampton 0, Bolton 2, Shrewsbury 0, Stockport 1, Stevenage 1, Wrexham 0, Wigan 1, Peterborough 0, and it's Reading 2, Burton Albion 0. In League 2, Bromley 1, Chesterfield 2, Carlisle 0, Notts County 2, it's Cheltenham 0, Accrington 1, Doncaster 0, Barrow 0, Gillingham 0, Grimsby 1, Harrogate 0, MK Dons 3, Morecambe 1, Bradford 0, Newport 2, Salford 0, Port Vale 0, Colchester 0, Tranmere 1, Swindon 0, and Walsall 2, Fleetwood 1. Plenty of games also in the Champions League this evening too, so let me round those up for you as well. In the early kickoffs, Brest won 4-0 at Salzburg, and there was a one-all draw between Stuttgart and Sparta Prague. Arsenal lead PSG by 2-0. Havertz and Saka, the goal scorers there. Barcelona comfortable for them against Young Boys, the Swiss side, 3-0 for Barcelona. Leverkusen 0, AC Milan 0. Dortmund running riot against Celtic. They lead by 5-1, the German side. And there were 3 goals in the first 11 minutes, actually. Celtic equalising after Dortmund had gone ahead. But then, as I say, plain sailing, it seems, for Dortmund after that point, and they lead by 5-1 now. Inter Milan 1, Red Star 0, PSV 1, Sporting 0, and Slovan Bratislava 0, Manchester City 2, Gundogan and Foden, the scorers for Manchester City. In the Lowland League, Berwick Rangers trailing by 1-0 to Bowness United at Shieldfield Park. And just to remind you as well, the big news elsewhere today, Rob Elliott has left Gateshead for Crawley Town along with coaching staff Lewis Story and Anthony Sweeney. Ben Clark taking charge of first team matters on an interim basis, and he will be supported by Jacob Butterfield, Greg Olley and Luke Clark. Plenty more to come at full time in the matches. Second halves to follow shortly.
Half-time highlights.
Total Sport. North East.
BBC Radio Newcastle.
Fabian Schär's going to take the penalty. Captain tonight. End of the first half. Schär from 12 yards rolls it into the net. As cool as you like. As cool as Fabian Schär always is. And with 4 minutes added to the first half, they break the deadlock from the penalty spot. Fabian Schär. Newcastle United 1, AFC Wimbledon 0.
Yeah, decent penalty, wasn't it?
Total Sport, North East.
The EFL Cup.
BBC Radio Newcastle.
Thank you to Simon Pride. And here at St James's Park, Newcastle are going to make a change at half-time. In fact, there's going to be a couple of changes. And we are going to see goalkeeper Odysseus for a debut. With Martin Dubravka having had a problem at the end of the first half, there's a change in goal. And also coming on is Bruno Guimaraes. So, two changes from Eddie Howe here at the break. The skipper and backup goalkeeper Odysseus, preferred to John Ruddy, who went out to warm up when Dubravka went off. Or went down initially, and Newcastle double change coming. Rest of the players are back out there, and AFC Wimbledon now join us for the second half. You listen to BBC Radio Newcastle and NUFC TV. If you want Sunderland's match on BBC Radio Newcastle, it's DAB and Freeview Channel 711 for the coverage from the Stadium of Light. Debut for Odysseus, on he comes for Dubravka, and the other change is Bruno for Barnes. And Harvey Barnes, his night is over. Joe Linton's gone to the left side of the attack. Wimbledon are unchanged for the start of the second half. So Newcastle, Odysseus in goal. They've also changed things at the back positionally. Kraft is now at right back. Schär and Kelly are the centre halves. And Livramento is at left back. Bruno in midfield with Longstaff and Willock. Almer on right, Joe Linton left, and Osula up front. Second half is underway. And Newcastle shooting towards the Gallagher end, the right hand side, as we look at the action. And it's a Wimbledon throw. The team from Wimbledon: Owen Goodman in goal, Hussein Bylett, Joe Lewis, Riley Harbottle, Isaac Ogundeer and James Tilley. Their back five: James Ball, Callum Maycock, Miles Hippolyte in midfield, Omar Bugle and Joe Pickett in attack. 1-0 the score through Fabian Schär's penalty, and Schär's diagonal ball to the left to Joe Linton. Up the line to Livramento. Double substitution and positional changes here at the start of the second half. Kraft in the 47th minute to Almiron, having his shirt pulled by Tilley. Bruno into the action, playing it to Almiron on the near touchline. Cher helping it into the box. Joelinton makes the run, but the ball's too straight. Decent idea, but not quite the right delivery on the pass. So they've changed it around. Ando, Bruno on, Odysseus on in goal. And the back four, they've moved three of them into new spots.
Yes. Yeah. Interesting.
Wimbledon have the ball on the right-hand side of midfield. And they get a throw. BBC Radio Newcastle. 1-0 to the Magpies. Looking to get through and play Chelsea in the next round. Last time they went out at this stage, the third round, was in 2015. A dismal night at St James's Park. Defeat by Sheffield Wednesday. A real low point in a horrible season. Bruno with a long ball forwards. Osula chasing. He can certainly shift William Osula, and he made the goalkeeper play it from well outside his box. Bruno on to Almiron. Osula in the middle, offside at the moment. Almiron plays it to Bruno. Threads it through to Longstaff, tries to dink it up to Osula, back post. It's corner. Hit the defender on the hip. Don't think it was handball, despite some fans appealing for that. Lloyd Kelly, Fabian Scher make their way into the penalty area. Sean Longstaff takes the corner kick. It's a Wimbledon header clear from Bugle. Kelly to Willock, Scher's available inside. He drops back into the centre circle to get it. On to Almiron. Kraft on the outside, given to Longstaff, now Kraft. And Kraft is tackled, Bruno wins it back, finds Willock in the area. Joe Willock wins another corner.
Better, a bit quicker, a bit sharper.
Willock himself will take this corner. Longstaff is just a couple of yards back from him. They're saying Wimbledon defenders aren't far enough away. Now they roll at Newcastle. Willock to Longstaff. Almiron, Livramento in the centre. Sends in the cross to the back post. Oh, Bruno threw himself at it with his right leg.
Should have went with his left.
Across his body and behind, but very nearly connected with Livramento's cross. And that could have been 2-0.
Yeah. Corner off the training pitch again, wasn't it? He's gone with his right, wrong foot.
Well, we thought we might never see Odysseus in goal for Newcastle, but rather than John Ruddy, with Martin Dubravka off at half-time, they've gone with the Greek. And he did play in the pre-season game against Brest in August. In the second half, he's played the Champions League for Benfica. He's number one for Greece. He's clearly a capable goalkeeper, but signed in sort of curious fashion, all related to PSR. Hasn't even travelled to some away games. They've taken an academy goalkeeper instead, but I'm sure you'll be hoping that he leaves tonight with a clean sheet behind him in his 45 minutes. Although if he doesn't, he might be needed in a penalty shootout.
Well, I mean, to be fair, Wimbledon didn't do enough in the first half to suggest they've got a threat, did they?
Yeah, well, their one attempt came after an offside and it involved a collision with the goalkeeper. Livramento to Joelinton. Cher, Almiron's free, but Cher plays the pass straight to Tilly. And Bruno putting pressure on as the away team, Ogundir, get it clear up to halfway.
Chair and Longstaff now on the near touchline. Almiron takes over. Taken down Almiron by Hippolyte. Not a good tackle. And yellow card for Miles Hippolyte of AFC Wimbledon. Darren Bond just making a name, puts his yellow card back into his pocket, making a note of the name. On the right, 10 yards into the United, to the Wimbledon half, they go backwards with the free kick and switch the play to the far left hand side in front of the East Stand. 1-0 up after 52 minutes. Joe Linton. Kelly playing at centre half now, having started at full back. Probably is more comfortable in the centre, Lloyd Kelly, rather than in the full back position, which is where we've tended to see him since his arrival in the summer. Wimbledon in a bit of trouble in the corner on the far side, and they've won a free kick. Not for you.
Yeah, free kick.
Joe Linton, no, that's why you're chuckling.
Yeah. Had him boxed in, there was no need to give the boy, wasn't going anywhere.
Anthony Gordon and Jacob Murphy sprinting up and down the touchline.
Wonder where they will. Stay warm.
Yeah. Well, it hasn't rained again, but it's a breezy night. Temperatures are dropping. Bruno to Kraft. Lots of space for Kraft to run into. Reaches halfway. Back inside to Bruno. He's got a player just on his left shoulder and switches the ball to Joe Linton, but he can't control. And it's out on the far side. Newcastle's last win over a Wimbledon team included a couple of goals from Duncan Ferguson in November 1998 at St James's Park in the Premier League. We talked earlier about how they used to struggle against the old Wimbledon. It's the last time they beat a Wimbledon team. And in Newcastle United trivia, Alan Shearer's first goal again for the club came against Wimbledon in 1996. Also in that match, David Batty scored from a long way out, didn't he? Lobbed the goalkeeper Neil Sullivan, who'd unforgettably been lobbed from halfway by David Beckham as well. Not too long before that. Newcastle on the attack with Longstaff, shifted and tried to find a little space for the shot. Then he's pulled back his man in midfield and could get booked. Longstaff, he does. It's a nice first touch, then he went just to try and push it inside away from a defender, having dragged it back, but lost out in the battle and then committed a foul to stop the Wimbledon break. Sandro Tonali is warming up now. And with 55 minutes on the clock, I wonder when we'll see further changes from Eddie Howe. Player down in blue, referee says play on. Wimbledon have then won it back through Bugle, who was on the floor, and then he was all right to get up and take part in that attack. Across from the corner on the right, headed away. And they're giving their fans something to get excited about, and there hasn't been much of that from the League Two team, but here's Tilly wide on the left. Back to Hippolyte and Tilly. And Almiron with a challenge. Osula makes a block. It's going to go out for a Wimbledon throw, 25 yards from Newcastle's goal. Still only 1-0. And it's another Wimbledon throw, pretty much in the same spot. Sunderland have a 2-0 lead now over Derby in the Championship. So double for Sunderland. DAB Freeview Channel 711 from BBC Radio Newcastle is where you'll find the Sunderland commentary. Here's the Wimbledon throw. Hippolyte into the area. Kelly volleys it away. Kraft with a header. then another one from Almiron, then Kraft clears, Osula and Almiron win the ball back, and now Newcastle can go with a 3-on-2. Almiron into the Wimbledon half, finds Willock, Osula in the middle, Willock takes it on the outside away from his man, then breaks into the area, Willock cuts it back, but there's a defender there to intercept, and then another one with the chance to clear, but he's running out of play, Byler. Newcastle with a throw, 30 yards out, aiming to keep the pressure on with Bruno from long range, straight at the keeper.
Threw his cap on it. Comfortable save. Opening up a little bit, isn't it?
Still the only goal.
Will do when tired legs. They've worked hard, Wimbledon.
Fabian shares penalty. Newcastle still holding the 1-0 advantage. Kelly with a header on the edge of his own box to Livramento. The Sunderland second goal, by the way, was scored by Wilson Isidore. One of their summer recruits. Kelly to Kraft, Almiron. Got two to take on, goes on the outside, finds Kraft on the overlap. Challenge comes in, and that is a corner. Wasn't sure who got the final touch, but it was Hippolyte. He was a League Two winner with Stockport last season, and then joined Wimbledon in the summer, the midfielder. He's been yellow carded. Slid in there, got the ball cleanly. Corner's been taken, Longstaff to Almiron. Now Bruno, back to Almiron. Bruno again, central position, 5 yards outside the box, decent ball in, flicked behind. It's Riley Harbottle who got the touch. Riley Harbottle up against Harvey Barnes in the first half. Their dads used to play together for Notts County.
Yeah.
Which is a great statistic. And now the two sons faced off, but Barnes replaced at half time by Eddie Howe, by Bruno, who's got the ball from the short corner from Willock. Back to Livramento, 30 yards out. Almiron in space in the D. Get players out to close him down, though, before he could do something meaningful. He's passed it to Bruno. Looking round the back for Joe Linton. Keeper's come and taken the ball. And there's a defender down, and this doesn't look good. Landed really badly. Goalkeeper collided over the top. I think he's okay. Just looked the way that he landed and went flat and still, but the Wimbledon medical team are on, and the player in question has got up. James Ball, Wimbledon midfielder, looked like he was flat out for a few seconds.
Yeah,
it was worrying. He's off the pitch getting treatment.
He's on his feet.
He's holding
just
his shoulder.
Just landed on his shoulder by the looks of it.
Thankfully, he's all right. We've played an hour. There are going to be changes from AFC Wimbledon. And nothing more just yet from Newcastle. Share in the box. Not sure Odysseus has actually touched it, even with his feet. Could have played it to him there. They instead go out to the left to Livramento. It's now on halfway with Bruno. 1-0 up, Newcastle. Back to Kelly. And what about that from Lloyd Kelly on the diagonal, but Almiron.
How can you be offside? You're looking straight across the line.
That's disappointment. He won the penalty, Almiron, for Cher. Eddie Howe's now got two players ready. Lewis Hall is one of them. The other is Anthony Gordon. And I'm sure Gordon, like Bruno Ando, will benefit from the minutes they get tonight, because they are two players, Eddie Howe has said, haven't been at top fitness so far this season. Find out who they come on for in a second. Wimbledon are bringing on forward Matty Stevens and winger Josh Neufville. And they're taking off right back or right wing back Hussein Byler. He's had a tough night. And also Joe Piggott, striker. It's the double change. Newcastle are going to replace Joe Linton. And Emil Kraft is the other player coming off. Lewis Hall replaces Kraft, goes to left back. Livramento comes back over to the right side of defence, and Gordon in his
all change again
preferred left forward, left wing, left side of the attack role. Players all bunched together in the middle of the park as Wimbledon take the free kick for the offside. Shares header, Longstaff helps it on. Osula can't get there. Lifted up and away by the visitors. Livramento and Cher struggle to get it clear. Stevens, the substitute, with a header immediately after coming on. Then Livramento clears it. And Lewis beats Osula to the ball in the air for Wimbledon. Tilly through the legs of Longstaff. Bruno's got it back. Cher to Longstaff on the near side. Into Bruno, who now starts to come away. Osula running in behind. He might be offside if it reaches him, but Lewis didn't take the chance and sticks it out for a Newcastle throw on the near side. Whistle goes to make sure Newcastle take the throw from the correct position. Livramento to Bruno, and Kelly just inside the centre circle over to Lewis Hall. First touch since coming on. Played well on Saturday, didn't he, Lewis Hall?
Did, yeah.
Gordon looking for Longstaff, away it goes, and Odysseus is going to get a touch. There he is, outside of the right boot, and passes it to halfway to Livramento. Hasn't made a save yet, hasn't been needed in that sense. Livramento high up on the Newcastle right, wins a throw. Bruno to Almiron, middle of Wimbledon's half. Cher for Bruno, who's kept it moving since coming on. Gordon, first chance to run at defenders, cuts inside, into the box, then on the outside, gets blocked, has it back, lays it off to Bruno, on the stretch finds Cher, doesn't hit it, passes it instead to Livramento. Forwards to Almiron, on to Livramento again, and in the middle Osula, and Willock blocked, great block. Now Bruno beats his man. Bruno's shot blocked. Wimbledon still have a player down in the box. Referee says stop the game, could be a head injury. A couple of big blocks in there. Livramento's cross, he looked for Osula, and Willock blocked on its way through to goal, and then Bruno's follow-up effort likewise didn't reach the target. Unpick that for us.
Yeah, it's just hit him on the side of the head, hasn't it? Then Bruno appealing for a penalty, never going to be given. Yeah, I felt that one. Asul has hit that full on the volley. Boy, he was brave.
It's Riley Harbottle, and in the meantime Eddie Howe's called Tino Livramento across for a chat. Sean Longstaff's come over as well. Two players on this near side of Newcastle's play. Clock is in 66th minute and it's 1-0. And Harbottle's all right, but he's got to go off before coming back on, having had treatment on the pitch. It's 10 men at the moment for Wimbledon. The next two matches are away, so that buys them some time with their pitch. Salford and Crawley, now with Rob Elliott, having left Gateshead today, in charge. Hoping to be back, aren't they, at their home pitch in about 10 days' time when they play Carlisle.
Yeah.
Which, considering the state of it last week, It would be quite some quick progress, wouldn't it?
Yeah, it needed some work doing on it, didn't it?
And it would have been a totally different feel to this tie, wouldn't there, had it been played at Plough Lane?
Yeah, definitely.
And it would have been a nice trip for the Newcastle fans because they've not been there before as well. Livramento towards Longstaff in the box, put out for a throw. Definitely suited Eddie Howe, didn't it, to have it switched here?
Oh, yeah.
And also to have, you think, another full week to prepare for Manchester City too. Yeah. Gordon on the outside, then back inside, then a cross from Gordon, Almiron side netting, but it may have been out of play when he connected with it. Teasing ball in by Gordon, curling it towards the far post, and they just couldn't apply the touch.
Great ball in, wasn't it? Just checked back on that right side, whipped it in.
Now Almiron goes for it with his left.
Yeah. Yeah. Go with it with your right.
Like I say, I don't know if it was out anyway when he connected with it, so maybe it wouldn't have mattered, but it was coming on towards his right foot. Might have been easier. Wimbledon into the box. Odysseus catches the cross at the near post. And then throws the ball out over arm to Lewis Hall. On the halfway line now, Hall. Past the midway point in the second half. Still no second goal for Newcastle. Livramento back to Cher. They've got Bruno and Gordon on the pitch, brought on as substitutes. Hall trying to get one in behind for Gordon. It's well defended, but it comes as far as Bruno. And now Willock just outside the area, through for Osula. Well, low shot from William Osula, left side of the area, went wide of the near post. Didn't take a touch, but he got some power in that effort, just not the direction.
Yeah, better. His movement's better. Little ball played in, gets in. Good hit. Just wide the keeper's right-hand post. I think the keeper always knew it was going wide, to be fair.
Rolled the defender, Osula. And decent effort. He's had two shots tonight, both of them off target. Kelly back to Odysseus. And a long ball from Cher, looking for either Gordon or Willock, but it's a blue Wimbledon shirt that has it. And they pass their way through Newcastle here. They're only on the halfway line. And Tilly laid off to Hippolyte Osula. Makes the block, and then Osula with another challenge, and still going William Osula. Good strong play, really good play, bursts into the area, still got it, and the crowd enjoyed that. He's not come away with the ball. In fact, Wimbledon have it, and Hippolyte's done really well, and Longstaff's bundled him over, but it's competitive and physical from William Osula.
Yeah, better. Did seem very little of him in the first half. That energy, that desire wasn't there. He's shown a bit more of that in the second half.
Wimbledon staff complaining to the fourth official about something as they take the free kick that they were awarded quite rightly. And it's out off Newcastle. 30 yards from goal, throw. James Tilly began his career at Brighton, the player at left wing back. He left it for a teammate, and now he's helped win it back with a tackle. And an opportunity maybe for Ball to hit it, 5 yards outside the area, doesn't. They switch it to the far side. Lewis Hall gets a toe on the ball. Josh Neufeld, the intended target of the pass. And it's a Wimbledon throw, ball being dried on a blue jersey, and it's about to come in long. Here it is, and Odysseus comes and catches in the 6 yard box.
Off his line. Keeping, wasn't it?
Handling's pretty good.
Yeah, good goalkeeping.
Almiron wins a throw on halfway. Jason Tindall grabs the ball out of the hands of a member of the Wimbledon staff, gets Newcastle started. Here they go quickly up the far left hand side with Anthony Gordon. Hall on the outside has to come back with it. Lewis Hall under pressure. Kelly on the halfway line. 72 minutes played, 1-0 up. Fabian Scher with a penalty at the end of the first half. Almiron breaks away and then back out to the corner with the pass for Livramento. Finds Almiron again in the area. Spins, Livramento flicks it back to Bruno. It's nice stuff from Newcastle. Can they find an end product? Almiron still on it in the box. Fabian Scher hits one too high.
Yeah, decent build up. Kept it patient. Scher coming on to it, always leaning back, always over the top.
Still make another change. Eddie Howe, double substitution twice so far tonight. Jacob Murphy, Sandro Tonali, Alex Murphy, Dan Byrne are outfield players on the bench. Still, Osula chasing, a ball over the top, and keeper comes to the edge of the area. Does have pace, doesn't he?
Yeah, he's got pace. He, yeah, we've seen that in the pre-season game.
He's a strong runner, William Osula. Cher's header, Longstaff nods it on to Bruno, looks for Willock, cleared. Scher comes to win the ball in the air again. He's landed awkwardly and stayed down. Fabian Scher. Newcastle want the ball put out. The referee's having a look. It's not a head injury, it's like his left ankle. Wimbledon players telling their goalkeeper to get on with it. Longstaff's dropping into centre back. The long ball forward from the goalkeeper is going to go out for a Newcastle goal kick. Scher has been helped up by an opponent.
Is that right?
He seems to be fine.
He's fine.
We'd like your messages on the match on 08000 321 333. That's our WhatsApp number, 08000 321 333. And you need to put BBC at the start. We'll be with you till 10 talking about this one and Sunderland against Derby. It's 2-0 to Sunderland, and the commentary from the Stadium of Light, DAB, BBC Radio Newcastle on DAB and Freeview Channel 711. Gordon running at the defender, heads for the line. Goal kick. Gordon hit the deck as the challenge came in. Nothing given, it doesn't really appeal. Josh Neufeld went shoulder to shoulder with Gordon. Referee happy with that?
Yeah.
Just went looking for it, didn't he?
Headed on by Bugle. Scher is there to take it down and pass it to Hall. He sprints away and drops his shoulder and gets past Bugle and up to the forward line, but can't find Osula. Then Hall makes a challenge following the Wimbledon clearance. It's now on the halfway line. Lloyd Kelly gets in between man and ball. Fabian Scher covering, takes over. Longstaff at the back of the centre circle. 1-0 Newcastle. And 76 minutes on the clock. Almiron through for Livramento. Osula wants it. It's come to Willock. Just at the back of the D now. Bruno. Gordon through for Hall. Lewis Hall's cross. Too high for everyone. Longstaff keeps it alive. Right side of the penalty area. Livramento. Bruno comes to get it. 5 yards outside the box. Bruno beats his man. And then a curling ball in, but there was nobody there. And it's goal kick.
Wasn't the worst. A lot of bend, a lot of curl on it. Game's lost its way, hasn't it?
Just about to ask you what you make of the second half. They brought some big players on, and though, but they haven't been able to increase their lead.
No, but it's been very comfortable, hasn't it? It's, you know, Wimbledon, to their credit, of they've worked hard, but have shown very little in, from an attacking point of view.
Osula and Willock, they might be in. Joe Willock, big block, good defending to prevent Joe Willock from testing the goalkeeper. It bounced away from Osula, edge of the area. Willock was behind him running onto it, and then the shot was blocked. Kelly at the other end, back to Odysseus. He's very chilled out, isn't he, with his distribution. Looks unflustered, but he hasn't had any saves to make, so they've not had a shot yet.
No,
he did have to catch a cross. The Wimbledon fans, I think, would probably at least like a moment, even if they don't manage a goal. 1500 of them. Long ball from Newcastle towards the edge of the box. Wimbledon header straight to Willock, but then they wrestle it back off him. Header on there by Matty Stevens, one of the substitutes, one of the scorers in their draw with Ipswich at home in the previous round. Livramento. Almiron inside to Bruno. Willock could get it. 5 yards outside the area. Hall is free. It's back to Bruno. Livramento is available near side. Comes back to Livramento. Tackle comes in. And then the clearance up to Bugle, who's got his right wrist strapped, white bandage on it. And he's dispossessed by a combination of Cher and Bruno. Now the Wimbledon coaching staff are told to step back and not stand next to the manager. And Jason Tindall is told the same. At least the fourth official is consistent. Bruno threads it through. Livramento squares it, but blocked by a defender in the middle. Livramento's stayed down.
Oh.
Almiron now has it. It's not the best clearance. Newcastle still on the attack. Almiron back to him from Gordon. Feeds Hall. They sent him wide. Livramento picks himself back up in the meantime. Willock to Almiron. Longstaff. Livramento digs out the cross. Too high for Willock. Hall on his chest in the penalty area. Hall's cross. It's a Wimbledon header. And then Bruno on the volley. Deflected behind. Bruno from the edge of the area. Corner kick now on the Newcastle left.
Yeah, Wimbledon just hanging on now, aren't they?
Quickly taken by Gordon, back to Hall and Willock, and Bruno lifts it in. Sula having his shirt pulled. It's come out to Almiron. Headed away. Almiron on the half volley. Trying to guide it into the bottom left corner with his the inside of his left foot. Comfortable save for Owen Goodman.
He's just hurt the place, doesn't he? Comfortable for the keeper.
BBC Radio Newcastle, 1-0 United lead. Double change for AFC Wimbledon is coming. They've got the ball on the left, low cross to the near post. Cher puts it out for a throw. in the 82nd minute. And it's going to be another long throw. And it comes from Hippolyte. It's bouncing around in the 6-yard box, and then it's cleared. Gordon chases after it, and Harbottle gets there, plays it against Gordon, and it's stayed in, but there's a covering defender to roll it back to the goalkeeper. Long ball up the pitch, Kelly's header away. Longstaff in the middle back to Livramento, who, like Cher after an earlier knock, seems fine. Bruno wanting to play forwards. It's Longstaff back inside to Bruno, along halfway to Hall. Gordon drops his shoulder, comes back with it, passes it to Kelly. Left footed ball across the centre circle to Livramento, up the line for Almiron. Osuna in the middle, big defender Harbottle at his back. Bruno and Longstaff exchange a couple of passes, the right side of central midfield, and then Longstaff through for the run of Willock into the penalty area. Willock holds it up, and tackle comes in, but it's a fair one, and the clearance is straight towards Jason Tindall. Newcastle's ball from the throw. Triple change from Wimbledon. 83 minutes have been played. Livramento to Longstaff in the centre circle, coming over to the far left hand side with it. Hall on for Gordon, closed down by Neufeld. Gordon with Hall nearby, slows it down, passes it back to Longstaff. Quicker tempo now, Bruno into the box towards Gordon, but he's dispossessed, and Bugle tries to turn.
Hasn't got the
chase,
pace, has he, Bugle?
But Kelly's there first.
Yeah, they've got no outlet, Wimbledon. Just keeps coming straight back at them.
Almiron dicks it up, Longstaff in the box. Corner. Played it off the defender, who went to close him down. Went wide at the near side of the goal. Remember, if it's level after the 90 minutes and additional time, it's penalties, but there's been no threat from AFC Wimbledon tonight, really. Newcastle will look to seal it here with a second goal from the corner. Taken left-footed on the right by Lewis Hall. It's a high one. It might be too high. It's kept in by Willock, actually. And then cleared into the middle of the Newcastle half. Dan Byrne is going to be next on and last on for United. They're encouraging Fabian Scher to shoot when the ball comes his way. He's almost on the halfway line. Even for him, that's too far back. Almiron, 1-0 up. Scher's penalty, the only goal. He's a bit closer this time, Fabian Scher. Passes it to Lewis Hall. Joe Willock is wide left. Osuna wants it in the middle. Willock's cross, too close to the keeper.
Yeah, easy take for the keeper. That final ball, isn't it? Just the quality on that final ball.
A few fans heading away early, seemingly satisfied it's job done. Still 5 minutes to play. Gordon tackled near to the halfway line. They've got it back, Newcastle, through Hall, and Bruno stabs it towards the goalkeeper, Odysseus. Very comfortable.
How long have these substitutes been standing there, Razor?
They've got three waiting to come on. Ball hasn't gone out for a good couple of minutes. Yeah, Dan Byrne for Newcastle, waiting to be introduced as well. I mean, three lads, we're desperate to play at St James's Park. We've just lost a couple of minutes off what would be, anyway, a short appearance. Newcastle passing it around at the back. And the Wimbledon subs aren't going to get on. They keep doing that. Now Bruno into the attacking half. And then back to Cher. Longstaff. Livramento. Near to the touchline. Gets it back from Almiron. Inside to Longstaff. 3 minutes of normal time remaining. Feel for those Wimbledon players.
Eh?
Feel for those Wimbledon players. Still have another chance to come on. Gordon to Willock. Dispossessed. Stevens, surrounded by black and white shirts, heads out to the far touchline and passes it forwards. Stays in play though.
Just can't keep it, can they, Wimbledon?
1-0 Newcastle lead. In behind, Willock leaves it for Gordon. Only Osula in the box. Gordon on the outside again and then tackled. That one didn't quite come together. Cher now with the man at his back, plays it to Odysseus and he moves it forwards quickly to Hall inside to Bruno. One of the substitutes has put his bib on and gone for a jog up the touchline.
Probably trying to stay warm.
2 minutes of normal time remaining. Dan Byrne waiting as well. He's got a big grin. Here's Osula. Goalkeeper comes.
Did well.
And slides in at Osula's feet. The ball whipped forwards along the turf and Osula had a sniff of it and used his speed to try and get on the end of Lewis Hall's pass. Didn't really connect. I'm not sure he even touched it. And Goodman did well. Kelly, and now it goes out and now the substitutes can come on for Wimbledon and they've got 90 seconds of 90 minutes. Off is going James Tilley, replaced by James Furlong, Irish under 21 international on loan from Hull. Also coming on is number 10, Josh Kelly, and he is replacing Callum Maycock, and Miles Hippolyte is off, and Alistair Smith, who's a midfielder on loan from Lincoln, is on, and Dan Byrne replaces Fabian Cher, who might well be Newcastle's match winner tonight, that note.
Yeah, penalty took it away. I mean, it's 1-0, but they've never been in any great danger throughout the game. Wimbledon haven't asked any questions at all, to be fair.
BBC Radio Newcastle with you till 10. And you can get in touch with us on WhatsApp 08000 321 333. BBC at the start of your message, or on Twitter or X, it's at BBC Newcastle. A minimum of 5 minutes of additional time at St James's with Newcastle 1-0 up. Bruno Osula trying to get in behind. It's a bouncing ball. He's brought it down edge of the area, back heels to Gordon. Still Gordon, shot blocked. Osula wanted it rolled back to him so that he could get the effort away. Unable to do so, and now Wimbledon through Furlong. Short ball up the line to Stevens, in behind. Furlong's carried on his run. Kelly, who's gone to right centre back, with Cher having been substituted, just watches it behind.
Just can't keep the ball.
It's been a nice, a very few moments for the League Two team. Newcastle after the first minute of additional time. Just need to see this through. They've lost it though. 25 yards from their own goal. Bruno had it and gave it to Wimbledon. Furlong on the near side. Ball in midfield. And then Smith. Possibility of an attack. Furlong sends the cross in. Livramento heads away. Osula on his chest. Holds it up. Back to Longstaff. Bruno under pressure. And he passes it to the goalkeeper. And Odysseus for Byrne. And Hall. Long pass from Lewis Hall. Anthony Gordon onto it. Gordon, good defending
by
Joe Lewis. Although Gordon's gone down as if he's being kicked. We need good to see defending. It again. Looked like the defender got the ball though.
He won the ball as clean as you wanted.
And Wimbledon play on. Gordon is still down. 93rd minute. Dropped in behind. Away by Hall. Gordon still down as Willock turns and runs and beats another player. And Willock has got it on the left wing. Gordon starts to get up as Newcastle go on the attack.
Yeah, exactly.
Into the centre of midfield. Wimbledon, tired bodies, struggling to get back to support the defensive effort. Longstaff up to Osula and back again to Bruno. Looking for Almiron in the box with a through ball cleared. And then Dan Burns header to Lewis Hall. Staying on the attack, Newcastle. Willock. Just over 2 minutes of additional time to play. They lead 1-0. Looking to wrap things up and confirm it with a second goal. Bruno finds Livramento on the near side. Back into the middle to Bruno. 10 yards away from the penalty area. Almiron to Livramento. On to Gordon. Through for Almiron. Went for the return to Gordon. But he didn't make the run. And Byrne under pressure from Stevens back to Odysseus. Fires it out to the far touchline and Hall plays it forwards to Gordon. As Gordon spins and confuses, bamboozles three Wimbledon players. Longstaff for Livramento. Osula just outside the box.
Needs to be stronger.
Was the challenge from Lewis, who is a big boy, knocked Osula to the floor and Wimbledon into the penalty area. Byrne volleys it out. A minute to play, 1-0 Newcastle. They've got a chance to put a long throw into the box. Now they aren't sending the goalkeeper up, but everybody else has gone up and Newcastle have got everybody back. If they were to score from this, it would almost certainly be penalties, because we go straight to a shootout if it's a draw. Final minute of additional time. Long throw into the middle. Flicked on and headed away by Newcastle. Then the shot comes in. It's blocked. Then another effort towards the bottom corner. Odysseus gets down quickly and could clear it up the pitch, maybe for Gordon.
It was a back pass, wasn't it?
It's not the best kick from Odysseus through the middle. Sliced it. Wimbledon with a long ball forwards. 15 seconds to play. Kelly, one of the substitutes, brings it down. Needs some support. Has it. Cross hung up. They've got two in the middle. Bugle. Furlong. Danger not clear. Now Lloyd Kelly nods it away. Referee blows for full time. Wimbledon with a bit of pressure in the final few seconds, having not threatened at all tonight. But they couldn't create the chance that could have given them a goal to take this to penalties, and it's Newcastle United who go through a 1-0 victory over opposition from League Two. Fabian Scher scoring the winning goal from the penalty spot in first half added on time after Miguel Almiron was fouled, and despite the introduction of Bruno and Gordon and others in the second half, Newcastle couldn't get a second goal. But even though the scoreline may not suggest it, John Anderson, you feel that it was a comfortable night?
Yeah, I mean, Wimbledon, to be fair, they came, they battled away, they kept going right to the death, but they didn't really carry a threat at all, did they? You know, two keepers we've had never had a save to make all night.
Mind you, in saying that, their keepers didn't have too much to do either. We had all the ball, we controlled, didn't create a great deal, but it was comfortable.
You're right. In the both goalkeepers, or the three of them that played tonight, Dubravka in the first half, weren't busy at all. Eddie Howe had some big players on. I suppose Gordon and Bruno will benefit fitness-wise, but even the introduction of big names couldn't get Newcastle into the right sort of positions and create those moments that they would have needed for more goals.
Yeah, we didn't create a great deal. We had plenty of the ball. A final ball, our decision making at times was poor again, and a final ball into the areas just wasn't great. But look, in cup competitions, it's all about getting into the next round, and that's what we've done.
Newcastle are through. Fourth round tie will be on Wednesday the 30th, end of this month, against Chelsea here at St James's Park. And we'll bring that to you live here on BBC Radio Newcastle. We bring you every Newcastle match and every Sunderland match exclusively live. Sunderland playing against Derby in the Championship. 2-0 up at the Stadium of Light, Sunderland. And they're into the final stages of that game. We're going to be with you till 10 tonight on BBC Radio Newcastle. If you want to send us a message, text number 81333. Start your message with BBC if it's a text, 81333. WhatsApp 08000 321333. And we also need BBC at the start of your WhatsApp messages. Sunderland have won 2-0. They've just finished. So they'll have Chelsea twice in just a few days, Ando, at the end of the month.
Yeah, I mean, obviously go to Stamford Bridge, and then we've got them back here that week. I think it'll be a different type of side that he puts out that night as well. Look, he played fringe players tonight. Did any of them stand up and say, you've got to play me at the weekend against Everton? Probably not. Sula was really quiet first half, did a little bit better second half. But we're in the next round, and that's all that matters.
Yeah, sold out St James's Park. Saw only one goal tonight from Fabian Scher from the penalty spot, but it was enough to take Newcastle through. And that's what it was about, reaching the fourth round of the League Cup. Could be a good week, couldn't it? You know, they've got the job done tonight, played well, and got a positive result against the champions, Manchester City, on Saturday. Everton coming up away from home, 5:30 on Saturday at the end of the week, Ando. I know they got their first win of the season, beating Crystal Palace, but it's an opportunity to round off this block of games with a good result on what could be Newcastle's final trip to Goodison Park, be their final league visit there.
Yeah, it will be, you would think. Whether Everton are still in the Premier League or not come the end of the season remains to be seen. It's never easy going there, you know. It's always difficult, and they're very rarely good games as well. They're usually slogs. You have to dig in and get something out of it. But look, we go there in good heart.
Yeah. For the moment, thanks very much,
no bother,
Ando. But John Anderson will be here with Simon Pride and Gary Bennett up till 10 o'clock on BBC Radio Newcastle. 08000 321 333, BBC at the start of your message on WhatsApp. We'd love to hear from you. Newcastle United have beaten AFC Wimbledon in the Cup by 1-0.
Matt Bailey at breakfast.
This morning I want to know, when have you made a lasting impression? Gilly from Frostley, yours happened at work, yeah?
My son had dropped me off. Two customers shouted, Gilly! I just ignored them. My colleague come in and she went, Gilly, do you realise that your skirt is tucked in your knickers? Oh my God! That's what they were trying to tell me, and they come in every single day. I couldn't look them in the face.
Why did your son not tell you? He watched you walk across the car park.
I ran him up, I went, did you not realise? He was like, no, Mum.
Matt Bailey at breakfast. Back tomorrow when you wake up. BBC Radio Newcastle.
And this is Simon Pride at St James's Park. We're on air until 10 o'clock tonight, so you might just get time to have your message read out to John Anderson here, to Gary Bennett at the Stadium of Lights. Two victories to talk about then. Newcastle beating AFC Wimbledon in the Carabao Cup here, and Sunderland, well, potentially going to the top of the Championship again this evening, having dispatched Derby County by 2-0. While Benno and Ando collect their thoughts, I will just rattle through the scores elsewhere just to keep you on top of things. Starting in the Championship, Burnley, hot on the heels of Sunderland, have beaten Plymouth by 1-0. Cardiff have beaten Millwall 1-0, 3-0 for Coventry against Blackburn. So Blackburn Rovers falter in their push for the top of the Championship. Luton 2, Oxford 2. Luton pegged back from being 2 up by Oxford. Luton down to 10 men as well for the last 13 minutes or so of that game. Norwich 1, Leeds 1. Leeds, of course, Sunderland's opponents on Friday night at the Stadium of Light. Hull City have beaten QPR by 3-1. And Middlesbrough lead West Brom by 1-0 at the Hawthorns as well. Hayden Hackney has scored there. That one was an 8 o'clock kickoff, so they've still got a few minutes left to play. In League 1, Barnsley 2, Wickham 2, Birmingham 1, Huddersfield 0, Blackpool 1, Lincoln 1, Bristol Rovers 3, Charlton 2, Rotherham have won 1-0 at Cambridge, Mansfield have won 2-0 at Rob Elliott's new team Crawley, and Exeter have won on the road as well at Leighton Orient by 1-0. Northampton 2, Bolton 4, Shrewsbury 0, Stockport 2, Stevenage 1, Wrexham 0, and Wigan Athletic 3, Peterborough 0, as well as Reading 3, Burton Albion 1. And in League 2, Bromley 2, Chesterfield 2, Carlisle 0, Notts County 2, Cheltenham 2, Accrington 1. Doncaster have beaten Barrow 1-0. Grimsby have won by the same scoreline at Gillingham. MK Dons have won on the road 5-1 at Harrogate. It's finished Morecambe 1, Bradford 1, Newport 3, Salford 1, Port Vale 1, Colchester 1, Tranmere 1, Swindon 1, and Walsall 2, Fleetwood 6, would you believe. And in the Champions League, plenty of games tonight as well. Most of them haven't quite finished yet. The two early kickoffs finished Salzburg 0, Brest 4, Stuttgart 1, Sparta Prague 1. Arsenal lead PSG by 2-0. They're all in the very closing stages, though. Barcelona 5, Young Boys 0. Men against young boys. Leverkusen 1, AC Milan 0. Dortmund 7, Celtic 1. Inter Milan 4, Red Star 0. PSV 1, Sporting 1. And Manchester City 4-0 up at Slovan Bratislava. So, and by the way, Berwick Rangers lost in the Lowland League at home to Bowness United.